Hi all, welcome to Analytics School. If you guys are working on any analytics project, then the first thing we do is to look how the data looks like. So we can use select statement in SQL to print the top 10 records or top 5 records, or if you want to look the whole table, we can use select statement in SQL to see whatever the information is available in a particular table which we are trying to analyze. So for example, we want to analyze here orders table, which is an analytics school server. So what we can do is we are using select statement, select start from dbo.orders. It is going to print all the records. Now let's say if we want to see top 5 or top 10 records. This is Microsoft SQL Server, so we are using top 10. Or let's say if you are using Teradata, then you can use limit statement after orders. So here you can see, give us the information of first top 10 records in orders table. Using select statement is a naive approach, and it is absolutely fine if you're working alone on a project and if you just wanted to have a snapshot like how the data looks like. But let's say if you are working on a project with other team members where you have to share the information that let's say you have to send them a sample data as well as the information about the table, such as that what are the data types of the column is, whether the date field is saved as a string or as a date time field, and in what format it has been saved as, those sort of the information. And here you see there are like 15 or 20 columns are there. You can manually do it into an Excel sheet and you can send that particular information. But let's say there are 150 or 200 columns are there and you are working on a large project, means there are 5 or 6 tables are there and you have to build up an ER diagram as well as, manually putting up all the information what we are talking about, like the data types and all. It will be, it can be a cumbersome process and you might make mistakes. So in SQL Server, there are some inbuilt column names and a table. That particular table is information_schema.columns. And these are the inbuilt column names are there, which you can use to derive the information of the tables. So this particular table, which is an inbuilt table, information_schema.columns, is going to be very helpful for you to retrieve the information about the table, about the columns. So let's run this particular code. So you can see here, this is table catalog analytics school. Then this is the schema DBO. Then these are the tables which are there within this particular schema, which is orders, people, and returns. And then the column names. What are the column names are there in all those tables? Then what is the data type is there? Character maximum length, numeric precision, and all. Now let's say if you want to retrieve the information about only one table, then we can use table_name equal to, let's say, orders, and then you will see the information only about the order tables. So this is going to be a better approach, and you will look professional also. If you are a beginner, then if you are sending a sample data to your team members with the information about the table, and it is going to be handy also when you are, because if you are working on analytics project and once a project is going to be deployed, then you have to do the documentation. These things are going to be very helpful for you and going to save a lot of time. In fact, this particular piece of the code is going to save a lot of time for you when you are doing the documentation, or if you have to share the information, let's say, with your data engineer who is building, let's say, the ER diagram. It's going to be super, super helpful for you guys.